I turned professional at 18 and 47. The Olympics is 30 years to the month that I turned pro. Can't retire before 30 years. Everyone's born into a certain dynamic with their parents, with their siblings if they have them, and we all react to our surroundings for whatever reason. My parents had a very struggling relationship. We didn't have much money. We basically lived hand to mouth. My mom was like spending her last dollar in the paycheck every week just to get us by. We lost our house that we lived in when we were kids. I had an older brother who really pushed me, and we were really competitive. I think that competitive nature and that probably the chip on my shoulder, just living in a small town that even in the world of American amateur surfing, East Coasters would just like look down upon, you know, like they're not as good as West Coast guys, and West Coast aren't as good as Hawaii. My first love kind of fell apart. This is all full psychoanalysis myself, but that fell apart, and a way to fill that hole in my heart was to just win. And all of that just went into the early mid 90s, and nothing could stop me. You know, I just had this drive that almost feels unfamiliar to me now. My first full year on the tour, I won the world title. And I felt like I could. I didn't feel like the level was above me. I didn't feel like the level was unachievable. I actually thought the level wasn't very good. I actually looked at it and went, you know, these guys suck. Like, surfing should be way above this. And that was the mindset that I had to have in order to be successful the way I wanted to be. When I was 21 years old, I was engaged. I was doing really well, making money, winning, blah, blah, blah. And then the next year I found out I was totally broke and in debt, actually. And then my relationship fell apart and I almost fell off the tour that year. And so I just went, okay, I'm gonna get this thing together and see how far I can go with it. And so that was where I went 5 years in a row winning world titles. As an athlete, you go through different stages. You turn pro and you're the guy that hopefully everyone else is looking out for, like, oh shit, here he comes. If you get to the peak and you're setting the standard, everyone's trying to catch up. And then as the level catches up, because it does in every sport to every athlete, it's surely going to surpass by a long ways whoever's at the top. So, you know, at some point you're not that guy setting the bar. And, you know, guys can do stuff that you can't.
I had a blast. If ever heat was that fun, I wouldn't mind losing every heat. That was a blast. I'd love to do it again right now. That was fun.
John Florence hits it off the lip and crushes the finish.
As far as the abilities right now, I think John and Gabriel Medina, they're going to just be fighting over world titles for the foreseeable future. You might get an Italo in there or a Felipe if they can pull up the consistency a little bit, because they got the skill, they got the surf skill to be with those guys. I'm probably rooting for John. You know, I've known him since he was 7 years old or something. I feel like I was like one of his uncles looking out for him at the beach with his two brothers when they were little kids and making sure they're safe in the water and that kind of thing. And he just turned into such a great surfer.
What are these two guys doing? What are
they doing? I would literally help anyone who asked me, any of the tour guys. I know that I'll compete against them, but like the idea that they would respect me enough to come and ask me to share knowledge with them, you know, I think it's sort of my duty at this point to do that if somebody were to ask. I probably wouldn't have been that way 20 years ago. There was a time when I was like, why the F did I do Baywatch? You know, it was driving me nuts. But it actually drove me competitively to be better because I got a lot of crap for it, you know? And it was hard for me to just own it and be like, I did it, deal with it, you know? Don't be jealous or whatever, you know? And instead, I sort of became the victim of like getting made fun of instead of just like owning and going, yeah, I did that and it was awesome. At this point, I look back, I'm like, that's hilarious. If I saw someone on tour doing that right now, it'd be so crazy to think, like, on a show that is that big. I had a lot of sadness this year, you know, as you come to the end of a cycle of something in your life. I guess equally exciting and sad, and it's been such a big part of my life.
How long is it each trout? 35 minutes.
I honestly don't know when I'm going to retire. I'm going to just announce it the day it happens, I think. Pretty happy. If I'm not happy with what I've done, I got a serious mental issue. Maybe I have a serious mental issue because I've done all that. I don't want my legacy to be dependent on my career, to be honest. I'd like to sort of be done with it and just have life be good. That's the most important thing, I think, in the end.